Hello, I have here the LEGO Icons Transformers G1 Bumblebee built in its default form, which is as a car. They have you build it this way first because this is the more dense mode of it, so it's easier to push all the parts together during assembly when it's like this, and then they have you transform it into the robot mode if you want to. In this video, I'm just going to be doing the transformation into robot mode casually. There is parts forming. This has to come off first. I'm going to put it off to the side, but again, emphasis on casual and doing it without any cuts and doing it in real time for folks who are just interested in the experience and seeing what it looks like to go through this again in real time. And this might not be the most optimized order of operations here, and it's definitely not going to be the exact order of operations that they recommend in the book, because I'm just not I'm not caring about that here in this particular case. I'm just converting because I want to, and then I'm sharing that experience. So if you're interested in buying this thing, maybe this will help you to understand. If you're not interested in buying it, you get to see what it looks like anyway, the process. This from straight needs to go back 2 clicks from what I've seen. Taking it back 2 clicks gives you the correct offset there, and then this can come into place. This looks like it wants to be attached. The studs want to be attached, but they actually don't, so you don't have to worry about that. I'm gonna go ahead and move to the feet. I like what goes on with the feet here because these are attached with just a couple of clips. This goes out one click here, and then there's kind of like a gate. This opens up, and that's gonna close back down once I rotate it. But before I rotate it, I do have to get this out of the way. You may need to move the bumper down just a little bit. Get this out of the way, then rotate the top of the foot forward on both sides. Bumper out of the way, toe, top of the foot, rotate this back, and then this thing that I called a gate goes back down. I like that, it just feels good. Same thing on the other side. And then all this can just be kind of tightened up, bring it in towards the leg there. It'll fit into a slight slot, and then you can take the doors and they just fold up partial accordion style like that. There we go. Now I can work on the top. Go ahead and bring the arms down partway. Do need to fold the bumper in, the ends of the bumper in, and all this will just fold back at any time. It all just folds back. Make sure the top here is flat, so that goes all the way down, and then the back is just kind of loose, and just let it open up. Bring the arms down like so. Now I can operate the elbows if I want to. This needs to fold up right here, and then the whole thing can rotate around. Oh, sorry, wrong way, this way. And I can open up the fingers, so open up the hands in there and just pose that however you want. On the other side, it's the same thing, but there's one specific thing here, over here. So open this up, rotate this out, open it up all the way, and I'm gonna go ahead and put the gun on there to get that to fit nicely. I do want this to splay out, want the arm to splay out a little bit, and then rotate the wrist outward. This is just attached with a single clip down underneath, and I can close up the fingers on that. And the reason I rotate it out is to give myself room so that I can have a fairly straight pose, so it's held fairly straight out like that. Over here, again, I don't care so much. And then just with this, fold it up like so, close up the mirrors, make sure that they're relatively straight, and this goes on the back as what they call a jetpack. So LEGO had to do some of their own work and take some creative liberties, like many, many designers in the Transformers world have done in the past, including with fully canonical things. Make sure that goes on there. What I'd like to do here is connect it to the topmost black anti-stud. So don't connect it to the gray, connect it to the black. The gray, the next time you transform it, will tend to want to come off. I'm not sure if that's exactly where it should be, but it's what tends to work comfortably for me. And there you go. You don't have a whole lot of range for posing with this. Oh, forgot this. Almost forgot this. There we go. Now we are set. But you can see my full review over on my LEGO Reviews channel, and I will do a separate video putting it back into its car form. That's it for now. Thank you for watching.